My name is Peggy. I have worked in Google for 3 years and Facebook for 3 years as well.
So I will give you about 2 minutes to introduce yourself. Let's get started.
Actually, that is my first time to write code and speak in English.
我们今天的主题是 Mark Interview, Topic will be Leetcode. So it will be me、as the interviewer and Handsomeboy as the interviewee. Which question do you want to explain?
I pick 136.
So let me introduce myself first. I'm the interviewer today. My name is Peggy. I have worked in Google for 3 years and Facebook for 3 years as well. So、could you introduce yourself for a bit?
I am a recent graduate of Chongqing University and...I have experience in Orient, and my language is C++. I'm good at data structures, complexity theory, and algorithms. And I can collaborate with my teammate very well because I'm a friendly guy, and I have a fresh liver. Please let me join you.
Thank you. So I want you to do live coding right now. So I have 3 questions over here. You say that you want to do 136. So let's do it.
Okay. As the question says, each element appears 2 times except for 1. So I have to find that 1. And I would like to know how many times each element appears and to record the correspondence between the number and the time it appears. I think map is suitable for record this relationship. So I will type this line. I want to visit all the elements in the nums. If I use the chunk in our chat, I take the nums, as example. If we meet 2, the record 2 will pass 1. This is the 2, the elements counter. We will plus 1. And the next time we meet 2 again, we will plus the count 1 again. Okay, and the third time I meet 1, I will make recorder plus 1. Means this element appears 1 time. After doing this for loop, I will have key value pairs for each element and its times. Now I want to visit all the pairs of recorder. The recorder is the map at the 8th line. So if the pair's value is 1, means the key, it appears only 1 time. So that is our answer. So we just return the pair's key. Yeah, so that is our solution.
Thank you for explaining. Okay, thanks for sharing. Okay, so let's jump to the next person, which will be Brian. So Brian, are you ready?
Yes, hi everyone.
Hi, hello. Okay, so Brady will be the interviewer and Brian will be in the interviewee. So you need to choose 1 question.
I will choose 2 some.
Hi Brian, I'm Brady and I have about 1 year experience in backend, but I have about 7 years experience in semiconductor field. I just transferred my career to the backend and I'm the today's interviewer. So I will give you about 2 minutes to introduce yourself. Let's get started.
So, hi, Brett. I am software engineer with 3 years. Also backend experience, and I'm really passionate about software development. And in my spare time, I also do some kind of programming contest and open source project. So I think that's pretty much it all. Yeah, nice to meet you guys.
Nice to meet you. Okay, so should I explain this problem to you, or you could just start it?
It depends on you. It's all work for me. Yeah.
Okay, then.I will briefly introduce this question to you, and I saw you chose the 2-sum problem.
Yes.
Yes, this question, we will input an array of numbers, and we will input and target and two of the elements in the array. Summed up will be the target number, and you should find them and return the index array. Do you have another question?
Okay, so actually the description is really clear. So first, I will explain my thought. So for the two songs, first we can think of is we have to find pair of element to reach the target. So actually it's kind of like A plus B equal to target. Does that make sense to you?
Yes.
Okay, so maybe we can first to some movement, so we can do like this target minus A. We can move the A to the right side, so the target could be this one. So actually we can find B just to use target minus A to get the B, right?
Yes.
Okay, so in here I would want to use a hash map. So use hash map to put all the elements with the index, because the problem state, I just have to find exactly one solution. Once I find a pair, then I just returned. So in here, if I can do it in one loop to store all the elements and find the answer at the same time.
Okay, so you build up a map, then what's the next to do?
Actually, I build map and find a pair at the same time. So first, I will try to put all... I forgot to put all the elements into the map. Yes. Oh no! Could I still have time to explain?
I'll give you 30 seconds.
So first I will put all the elements into the map. Then just like I said, I will first find the complement, which is the target minus the equation I left here. So each element will find the complement. Then I will just check if the complement exists in the map. If it exists in the map, and then I can just return. Because the problem states this problem definitely have the exactly one solution. Yeah,
I think this solution is great enough. And maybe a little more question, how about the time complexity of this?
Okay, so in here, in order to build the hash map, we put all elements into a map which need a big O of n for space, and to iterate through all the array to check we have the right complement, which also take a big O of n to finish the whole algorithm. So the both time complexity and the space complexity would be the big O of n.
Okay, thank you. So next one will be Big Leo. Big Leo, are you ready?
Yeah.
So my name is Peggy. I worked for TSMC for a couple of years. So I have 5 experience in the background field. So I will be the interviewer for today's interview. Okay, so it's your turn for you to introduce yourself.
My name is Leo and I am a front-end engineer with 7 years of experience. And I have experience in Angular, and my strength include communication.
Thank you. So it's time for you to shine. You need to solve this question here. So which one do you want to choose?
I choose two songs. I will literal the array to find which two numbers can plus each other equal to target. I will declaration a function like that, and I will put the numbers and target as the parameters. I will write another for loop. It's very similar to previous one, and I also declare another parameter pose and another not, which is number in array, and I will plus them. And if j is not equal to I and the sum is equal to target, then we get the index array. That's it.
Brady to iterate through the array.
Thank you, Brady.
Candidate should kind of go through what they've done. You mean after they write down and explain at the same time, they do it like overall. Hey, I will cut. Could you make it faster?
Actually, that is my first time to write code and speak in English. Yeah, yes. It's pretty hard.
It's so hard. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
So Azen, is Azen the next one?
Yes.
Big Leo, could you be the interviewer this time?
Okay, I guess. Let me introduce myself. I am Leo and I am a front-end engineer with 7 years of experience. And I have experience in Angular. Could you tell me about you?
Okay, and my name is Azen.And I study computer science at National Taiwan Normal University. I pick single number. I will use C++ to solve this problem. What the problem context in the left?
I will give a non-empty array of integer nums. Every element appear twice, except for one.
Okay.
So we need find single one. You must implement a solution with a linear runtime complexity and use only constant iterators.
Okay, I must implement a solution with a linear runtime complexity. So I think I can use excluding all to solve this problem because excluding all has a special feature or function. I have two numbers to use this operation.And the result will to be zero. And if I have a number and a zero to use this operation, the result will not change. For example, left example 2, 2, 1. If I use an exclamation or 2 and 2 to use this operation, they will be zero. And I continue use that.Result to execute or the next number 1, it will be 1, and so that we can get the result 1. So I think I can use that operation to solve this problem. So in the first, I have a result to save the numbers array, the first element in numbers array, and use for loop.To traverse that numbers array. So, okay. So the next array will be use exclusion all to operate the each numbers element. And finally, I can in finish. Finally, I can return the result. So I think that makes sense. Yes, I'm finished. Do you have any problem in this code?
Do you have any questions or some problems you want to ask? So Leo, what do you think about Azen's code?
I think great.
Time complexity is big O n. The space complexity is 1 because I just use the result to save my result.
So that would be the final round of today's interview.It's really hard to do explain Leetcode or know better everything in English. I know. This is the end of today's event. And thank you, everyone. And you did a very good job. So you deserve a compliment. You did very great. So give yourself some applause. Fireworks. Thank you.
感谢大家观看，我是水球潘。水球软体学院是全民成长型的新型态软体社群。这里每个人都很充实、欢乐和友善，而且每天晚上我们都有线上的聚会哦。所以，赶紧从影片下方的讯息区点击连结，加入我们的脸书社团和 Discord 伺服器，赶快加入我们吧，我们都在这里等你哦。另外，水球软体学院的精华影片之后都会上传到这个水球软体学院的 YouTube 频道中，请各位也订阅一下水球软体学院的 YouTube 频道吧。那我们就下一次聚会中再见了。